He's the head coach of the Dallas Stars. He's our pal. He's Ken Hitchcock. Hello, Hitch. How are you?
Bob, how are you? Shanny, two times in 1 week.
I know. So
that's
pretty
unique.
Who would you vote as coach of the year?
Oh, Girard.
Yeah.
He's done an amazing job. And you know, so has Jared Bednar. Both guys have done amazing work. And, you know, Girard took... He did a great job in cultivating the cause, and anytime you can have a cause that you fight for every day that's right out in front of you, it's visual, it's verbal, it's like gold, and we always look for it. And you know, the great coaches of the world like Popovich and Ferguson there at Man U, they always found a cause, and Girard had it, you know. And he's really made great strides in building that team with that sitting right now in front of him.
But you would have to concede this, and I don't want to dwell on the Vegas situation, but since it came up, it's hard to even fathom that this is happening. I mean, I've been watching this since the beginning of the year. I went to Vegas, Hitch, and I
haven't heard that before. When did you go?
Yeah, I've gone. And I spent some time with McPhee, and I'm sure he'll concede that he's still astounded by it, but probably having the best time of his life, but really can't believe what he's watching every night. And I think the owner's probably the same way. And I could ask you to explain it, but it really is almost inexplicable, isn't it?
You know, I think to this degree, yes, but not the way they're playing, not based on when we looked at the lineup that was going to play, a lot of us looked at it in early September, and that's when they had 12, 13 defensemen, six lines.
Yep.
And we looked at that and we honestly felt that was an 85 to 90 point team.
Really? Huh?
Yeah, we did. And one of the things that was there was, they had a really high degree of hockey sense in that group. And they had 25 guys who had really top-end hockey sense. And you knew that they were going to be competitive as heck every night. The risk was, could you take third-line players and make them second-line players? And obviously, that's where they've hit the home run.
No kidding.
Carlson and David Perron, Marchessault, all those guys. They hit a home run with that. But as far as hockey sense and smarts, they had a lot of guys that knew how to play the game properly.
Well, okay. And they had a goaltender that was world class too. And I mean, you don't expect to get that, I think, when you're an expansion team, and that's a big plus.
We played them the first game of the year.
Yeah,
and we played as well as we could play. Fleury was outstanding, and as the game went on, we overwhelmed them early, but as the game went on, they clawed back in it, and it was a very emotional game for both teams. But you could see a lot of things, how dangerous they were offensively,
right.
And that's what they do. They maybe give up chances, but they got a lot of finish up front, and they got a lot of hockey sense up front, and they make you pay for making mistakes. And even watching last night, Columbus played hard. They played well, but Vegas makes you pay for your mistakes probably as much as any team in the league right now.
That second period when John's team decided it was going to run and gun for a while, they couldn't keep up. They just couldn't keep up.
Well, you talk about home ice advantage.
Yeah.
That team has home ice advantage. I'm telling you guys, playing in that building is like trying to play hockey in a rock concert.
It's unbelievable, I mean, isn't it?
It is so loud and so emotional, and there's so much going on. I mean, it's just a great experience, but it is really loud, and it is loud on the bench. I feel like every speaker is pointed at our bench. And
you don't think it is?
I don't know. I mean, it used to be like that when you played in Florida, but this is something else. Like it's fun just to walk from the hotel to the rink, and the atmosphere there is incredible, and they've got a great thing going there.
Okay, you talked about Girard making sure his team plays with a cause. What's your team playing with? I mean, you've turned that team around.
No kidding.
What's the cause that you've convinced them of?
I think what has helped us is we kind of changed the focal point of our team, and we've got good players, and Jim and the staff's done a great job, but one of the things that's happened on our team is some of our workers have elevated their game, and it's given us a different foundation than we had at the start of the year. Guys like Radek Foxa, Tyler Pitlick, and Antoine Roussel, those type of players, Hamu's pattern, they've elevated their game, and it's given us way more competitive depth than we had at the start of the year. We can play them against the other team's best players, and now we look for advantages rather than disadvantages, and it's really helped us. It's our foundation is work-based now, and it's really helped our team. And now, because we've had success doing it this way, our team's really pushing to buy in. And the players are sounding like coaches on the bench or in the locker room. They're helping each other through this stuff, and it's given us a really good foundation that we're competitive every darn night right now.
Okay, you got 33 games to go. How do you keep the pedal on the floor? How do you keep pressing without burning them out?
Well, look, Shani, this is the reality. If you expect to make the playoffs in the Western Conference and in our division, we've got to win probably 20 games out of the 33 that are left, which is a terrific record. And we've got to play even better than we're playing right now because we've got a couple of tough road trips coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And to win 20 games with 33 left, we're going to have to really play well. Our players know that, but it's going to take 100 points to get in the playoffs. And that's unbelievable, but that's what it's going to take.
Wow.
And it's going to be a hard goal for every team here. But you know, unless some of the teams start losing to the Eastern Division, it looks like 100 points is what it's going to take to get in the playoffs. So we know we've come a long ways, but we've got a long ways to go if we expect to make the playoffs.
Hitch, good job so far. I'm not surprised even a little bit. I don't think Mr. Shannon is even a little bit. Congratulations on 1,500 games, by the way. You're only the fourth coach in history to achieve that notable stat. I'm sure you're aware of it, and I'm also sure it probably doesn't mean a whole lot to you, but it is a significant achievement, and you're to be congratulated for it. And we wish you best of luck the rest of the way. Hopefully we'll have a chance to chat before the playoffs. Thanks, Hitch.
Okay, Bob. Yeah, thanks a lot, Bob. See you, Shane.
Okay.
Ken Hitchcock.